again welcome back to our channel Competitive Maths by Balaji. So we successfully completed 19 parts of percentage chapter. Now we are going with a new chapter, that is ratio and proportion. Okay, so in this chapter let us first discuss the basics and definitions of ratio and terminology. Okay, right. In our day-to-day life we come across many situations where we need to compare two quantities in the terms of their magnitudes or measurements. Okay, for example, at the time of school admission we compare the marks of students, whereas at the time of recruitment of police we need to compare the heights and weights of respective candidates. But generally comparison done in two ways. Generally the comparison is done in two ways. Come to the board. Comparison is done in two ways. First one is comparison by difference, and second one is comparison by division. Okay, comparison by difference. When we want to see how much more or less one quantity is than the other quantity, we compare by difference. When we want to need or when we want to see how much more or less one quantity is than the other quantity, we compare by difference. For example, Ram's weight is 50 kgs. Ram's weight is 50 kgs. And that of Shyam weight is 40 kgs. And that of Shyam weight is 40 kgs. By seeing this, we can say that Ram's weight is 10 kgs more than Shyam's weight. Or in other words, Shyam's weight is 10 kgs less than Ram's weight. This is the comparison by difference. Now, let us see second one, comparison by division. Okay, when we want to see how many times more or less one quantity is than the other quantity, we compare by division. Here we use the word how many times. Okay, right. For example, let us take the previous example. Let us take Ram's weight over Shyam's weight. Okay, we know that Ram's weight is 50 kgs and Shyam's weight is 40 kgs. Same units gets cancelled, 0, 0 gets cancelled, we get 5/4. This can be written as two types, or we get two statements from here. That is, Ram's weight equal 5/4 times of Shyam's weight, or Shyam's weight equal 4/5 times of Ram's weight. Okay, right. From this we can say that Ram's weight is 5/4 times of Shyam's weight, and from this statement we can say that Shyam's weight is 4/5 times of Ram's weight. Okay, this is comparison by division. Generally, which comparison makes a ratio? Generally, which comparison is known as a ratio? See, very important note is that when we compare two quantities by division, when we compare two quantities by division, we say that we form a ratio of two quantities. We say that we form a ratio of two quantities. Here, another note is that we compare quantities of same kind. Here, weight is same kind. And in the same unit, see, the kgs are same units. We compare two or more quantities of same kind in the same units. Okay, next. Let us come to the definition of ratio. What is the definition of ratio? The ratio of two quantities of the same kind, yes, The word is very important. The ratio of two quantities of the same kind in the same units is a fraction. The ratio of two quantities of the same kind in the same units is a fraction. That shows how many times the one quantity is of the other. Okay. Ratio of two quantities is a fraction. That shows that how many times the one quantity is of the other. Generally, the ratio of two quantities A and B is denoted by A is to B, or this can be written as, since by our definition ratio of two quantities is a fraction, this can be written as A by B also. Okay, here the A is called first term or antecedent, or it is called antecedent. Okay, next, and here B is called second term of the ratio or consequent. Here we use the symbol to denote ratio. This is actually read as is to. This is to. So that the ratio of two quantities A and B is written as A is to B. Okay, or in other words, A by B. That means A is to B is nothing but A by B. Okay, let us see some important key points of ratios that we have to remember always. Okay, next, some important key points about ratios. First one is that a ratio does not change when its first and second terms are multiplied or divided by same non-zero number. Okay, since we know that, for example, 6 by 4 is a fraction. 6 by 5, let us take 6 by 5. 6 by 5 is a fraction. When we multiplied to the numerator and denominator by the same non-zero number, the fraction remains the same. The fraction remains the same. Since if we cancel them in 4 table, 4 6 is 4 5, again we get the original fraction. In the same way, the ratio does not change when its first and second terms are multiplied or divided by the same non-zero number. For example, 6 is to 5. The ratio is being multiplied by 4. Then what we get? 6 fours are 24. Is to 5 fours are 20. So the ratio remains same as if we cancel 6 4 6 are 4 5 are. Again we get 6 is to 5. So that is, a ratio does not change when its first and second terms are multiplied or divided by the same non-zero number. Okay. Next, second one. If we add or subtract a constant, from each term of the ratio, there will be a change in the value of the ratio. For example, 6 is to 5 is our ratio. Then if we subtract 4 from each term of the ratio, the ratio will become 6 minus 4 2 is to 5 minus 4 1, but which is not same as 6 is to 5. There will be a change in the ratio when a constant number either subtracted or either added. 6 is to 5. If we add the same constant number to the first and second term of the ratio, what will we get? 6 plus 4, 10. is to 5 plus 4, 9. But 6 is to 5 is different from 10 is to 9. That is, if we add or subtract a constant from each term of the ratio, there will be a change in the value of the ratio. That's important point. Next, third one. The order of the terms in a ratio is very important. That means, that is, i.e., the ratio 2 is to 3 is different from the ratio 3 is to 2. Yes. The ratio 2 is to 3 is not same as the ratio 3 is to 2. Why? Here the first term of this ratio is 2. And here first term of the ratio is 3. And the second term of this ratio is 3. And second term of ratio is 2. So 2 is to 3 is not same as 3 is to 2. So that the order of the terms in a ratio is very important. By observing the terms of the ratios, we can say that whether they are equal ratios or different ratios. Okay. Next, fourth one. Ratios are always expressed in their lowest term. It is very important. For example, let us consider 2 is to 3. Further, it cannot be simplified. Further, it cannot be simplified. So, the ratio is in its lowest term. Take another example. 30 is to 45. 30 is to 45. But this ratio is not in its simplest form or lowest form. As we can cancel by 5 table. 5 6 5 9. Again, 3 2 3 3 2 is to 3. So, among 30 is to 45, 6 is to 9, 2 is to 3, 2 is to 3 is the lowest form or simplest form of the ratio. Okay? So that ratios are always expressed in their lowest term. Okay? Let us see some concept-based questions on ratios. Okay. Right. Ippudu questions chuddam. First one. If A is to B equal 3 is to 2, then 5a plus 2b is to 3a plus 4b equal to dash. Options are given. Answer is direct substitute a equal 3, b equal 2. A equal 3, b equal 2. Why? See here, degree of each term is 1. Degree of each term is 1. So we can apply direct a value 3, b value 2. Okay? See. Now that is 5a plus 2b is to 3a plus 4b equal to 5 into 3, 15 plus 2 into 2, 4. 15 plus 4, 19. So answer is C. But let us complete the second one also. A means 3, B means 2. 3 3s are 9, 4 2s are 8. 9 plus 8, 17. So answer is 19 is 17. See here, I will give a question. Can you find this one? That is, A is to B is 3 is to 2. Then find 5A square plus 2B is to 3A plus 4B square. Can you find this ratio value? Student, ikkada, the value cannot be determined. Cannot be determined. Explain this on children. Enduku anedi. Actually, ikkada nenu degree parimanam 1 1 1 undi. Degree of each term is equal. Hence, we can apply directly a by 3, b by 2. But see here, degree of first term is 2, second term is 1. Degree of first term is 1, degree of second term is 2. That is different degrees. Each term has different degrees. So that we cannot apply direct A, 3, B, 2. Why? The reason is that. Actually, this is A by B is 3 by 2. Actually, this is ratio. To make it value, we have to multiply a constant number to the first term and second term of the ratio. But then value look marginal. That is, now, A value is 3x, B value is 2x. where x is unknown quantity. Where x is unknown quantity. Let us substitute a by 3x, b by 3x now. Why? Because a is converted in terms of value, not in terms of ratio. Here also b is converted as in terms of value. Right. Now 5a square plus 2b by 3a plus 4b square. Ratio can be written as fraction form. Right. Substitute the value of a. A is nothing but 3x, that is 3x whole square plus 2 of 2x by 3 of 3x plus 4 of 2x whole square. So, ikkada x square term undi, ikkada x undamma, x nenu bayatiki laavachu. Take away the common term. In the first term we have x, in the second term we have x. Take away the common term x. In the first term 5. 3 square means 3 threes are 9. 9 5 is a 45 x. Okay. Okay, x ikkada undamma. X square nothing but product of equal factor x into x. Oka factor bayatiki velisthe inko product lo inkoka factor untundi. Okay, 2 2 is a 4. But x is common term kabatti. That equal 3 3 is a denominator lo kuda x common tiyandi. 3 3 is a 9. 2 square means 4, 4, 4 is a 16x. XX gets cancelled. That is 45x plus 4 by 9 plus 16x. Chudandi, ikkada A em kavachu 3 yokka gunijam. B em kavachu 2 yokka gunijam. Aithe, avi samana gunijalu eppudaitho teliyadu manaku. Kabatti, X is unknown quantity. X is unknown quantity. X is unknown quantity. So x yokka vilo telinanta varaku ee fraction yokka value manaku teliyadu. So that this ratio is cannot be determined. Okay, ikkada x is unknown quantity. X unknown quantity ainappudu ee fraction ni manamu ee ratio ni simplify chesi oka ratio roopalo telemu telemu kabatti ila unnappudu different different degrees prati term degree different different unnappudu aa ratio yokka value కనుగొనలేము. ఓకే, ఇది ఒక కాన్సెప్ట్ గుర్తుంచుకోండి. సెకండ్ క్వశ్చన్, ఇఫ్ 5a-3b ఈస్ టు 4a-2b ఈక్వల్ 2:3 దెన్ ఫైండ్ a ఈస్ టు b. ఓకే, కాంచి మల్టిప్లికేషన్ అంటాం, దట్ ఈస్ క్రాస్ మల్టిప్లికేషన్ చేద్దాం. 5a-3b / 4a-2b, ఎవ్రీ రేషియో కెన్ బి రిటన్ యాస్ ఫ్రాక్షన్ 2/3 బై క్రాస్ మల్టిప్లికేషన్. What we get? 3 5s are 15a minus 3 3s are 9b equal to 2 4s are 8a minus 2 2s are 4b. Okay? A terms ani LHS lo, B terms ani RHS lo teesukodam. 15a minus 8a, that is 7a. 9b plus 9b minus 4b, that is plus 5b. A is to be equal 5:7. So answer is D. Okay. Manam already dini percentage chapter lo chusam. Okay. Next. Third one is over. Chudandi ikkada each term degree equal ichadu. Each term degree equal ichadu. So direct you can apply x equal 3, y equal 2. Fourth one chudandi. A is to B is to C equal 2:3, 2:3:4. Then the ratio of A by B is to B by C is to C by A. See, ikkada nen direct A badlu 2, B badlu 3, C badlu 4 apply cheyochu chudam. A, B, C are unknown quantities. A, B, C are unknown quantities. What is the degree of A1? Degree of B1? B1, C1. All terms having equal degree. So, we can apply direct A by 2, B by 3, C by 4. That is, A by B means 2 by 3 is to B by C means 3/4 is to C by A means 4/2 is nothing but 2/1. Okay? Right. So, ee ratio ni fractions lo levu. Merge cheyalante LCM of denominator teeskondi ikkada. LCM of denominator 3 4s are 12. 12 is LCM. Multiply each term by 12. 2/3 into 12 is 3 by 4 into 12 is 2 by 1 into 12. Okay. 3 ones are 3 fours are. So 2 fours are 8. Is 4 ones are 4 threes are. 3 threes are 9. Is 2 twelves are 24. But ikkada ee method cheyakandi. Time waste. Ikkada direct chesayach. 3 fours are 12. 4 twos are 8. Is 4 threes are 12. 3 threes are 9. Is 1 12 are 12. 12 twos are 24. So answer is 8 is 9 is 24. Okay. Thank you very much. Deento ee class ni complete chestunnanu. ఇంకా ఎవరైనా నా ఛానల్ని సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేసుకున్నట్లయితే చేసుకోండి, కాన్సెప్ట్ వినండి. క్వశ్చన్ యొక్క సొల్యూషన్స్ అన్నీ కూడా చాలా ఈజీ వేలో ఉంటాయి. కాబట్టి నా ఛానల్ని సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేసుకుని నా వీడియో క్లాసెస్ని షేర్ చేస్తూ లైక్ చేస్తూ కామెంట్ చేయాలని కోరుకుంటున్నాను. థ్యాంక్ యూ వెరీ మచ్.